Once you log into your DICloak account, the first thing you'll do is navigate quickly to your profile settings. In the top left corner, select Create Profile. Now, fill in your basic information, profile name, remarks, choose or create a profile group, and select your operating system. Next, configure your profile with a proxy. You can create a new proxy or select one from your saved proxies if you already have it. We highly recommend configuring a sticky residential proxy. This prevents issues like abnormal platform detection due to changes in IP addresses when different members access the account from various locations or networks, reducing the risk of account bans. Once you've set it up, test your proxy connection to ensure everything works smoothly. Now, head to Account Settings. I'm using my ChatGPT Plus account as an example. To easily access ChatGPT Plus from within your site, just include the URL in your profile settings. This allows quick navigation whenever you run the profile. Adjust your general settings by disabling website pop-up notifications to prevent account details from appearing on the window. Then, enable multi-open mode so your team members can access the profile simultaneously. Configure advanced settings like interface language, time zone, geolocation, Canvas, WebGL, and more. Optionally, you can adjust launch parameters such as disabling notifications, extensions, and other settings. If you want to prevent your members from opening the development tools, you can use the -devtools flags command to block access. Once you're done editing, click Confirm to create your profile. Next, open the profile you just set up. You should see an interface that matches your previous setup. Log in to your ChatGPT account, and from now on, when you open this profile, you won't need to log in again. Just visit the site, and you can start using it right away. Once the profile is set up, it's time to share the account with your clients or team members. These steps are crucial, as you need to assign the correct roles and member group to ensure that each member has access to the right profile. Navigate to Team Settings on the left sidebar, then choose Groups to create a new member group and set the specific permissions. I'll name the group ChatGPT, add remarks if needed, and since I'm selling this account to my client, I'll give her permission to open and close the profile, along with access to the proxy checking feature. After the member group has been created, go back to the Team Settings, then choose Members to create a new member. When adding a member, select Internal Members. Here, you can customize the member's name, username, and password without needing to provide an email or any other details. Next, assign the appropriate permissions, including the member group, role, and manager. If your team has multiple admins, you can assign the relevant admin. Then, specify which profile they can access. This ensures there's no unauthorized usage. For example, she'll be in the GPT member group, set up as a staff member, and the profile she'll have access to is ChatGPT Plus. Once you've finished editing the member's info, click Confirm. You'll see this page pop up. Click Copy to share the account details, username, and password with the member. After they log in, they'll be able to access the profile and start using the shared account right away. You can use the global configuration feature to boost efficiency during the profile setup. By presetting parameters like data sync, browser settings, and more, you can quickly create a well-configured profile by simply selecting these presets when creating a new profile. Go to More, then choose Settings to access the global settings. I recommend turning on cookies to sync data. This way, when logging in across devices, you won't need to re-enter your username and password. Under Browser Settings, choose to restore the previous page, disable pop-up notifications, and turn off the account password confirmation pop-up. Then, enable multi-open mode so your team can access it. Next, enable website access restrictions and select your restriction method. I'll choose block access and enter the URLs I want to block for my members. Finally, select the active member group, confirm your settings, and you're all set.